My name is Darryl Purpose. I'm in the Blackjack Hall of Fame. I've been asked to leave casinos on 6 continents. I beat the biggest casinos in the world with these card counting computer shoes. Card counting is not cheating. It's just playing a game. The casino offers the game. You're gambling your own money. Do you want to play it well, or do you want to play it badly? People have this idea, card counting, you have to be a genius. The truth is, I could teach you to count cards in a day. It's about keeping track of the little cards versus the big cards. So you keep a running total. 2 through 6, you add 1. And for the big cards, 10, jack, queen, king, ace, you subtract 1. So you can see if that if your running count is positive, that means there's more big cards in the deck. And that gives the player an edge for a couple of reasons. The dealer has to hit their hard 16, and you don't. So the dealer will bust more often. You know a little bit about what's left in the deck. So you can move your bet up or down, and then you can vary the play of your hand. Card counting is about being good with simple math under pressure. Big cards are favorable to the player, and the small cards are favorable to the house. And that's what card counting is. I got way better than I needed to get. Finally, I went to a casino, and I saw a guy was betting the same way I was betting. He was Ken Houston. Ken was the, maybe to this day, is the most famous card counter. His thing was team play, where a group of players use signals to beat the casino out of their money and then split the winnings. I was invited to try out for the Ken Houston team. I went for this tryout and I had no idea what they were gonna do, and they handed me a deck of cards. They said, count this down. And I realized they're gonna time me. And I counted down.
+8.
And they say, 10 seconds.
Is that good?
And they say, that's the best we've ever seen.
It's good.
Yeah?
It's good. Put her there.
And they hired me.
So I'm in.
I was just a kid, just trying to find my way in the world while I was doing these big things, you know? This was the biggest blackjack team on the planet. All these other people on the team had already gotten steamed up. You know, they had already been caught counting a lot. So they sent me in, and they would have a big player come in and sit on the other side of the table, and it would be them that bet the money and them that won the money, but we would be telling them exactly what to do. A big player is somebody who looks like a losing gambler, and in fact, they don't really know how to play the game. Somebody like myself is sitting on the other side of the table, signaling them how much to bet and how to play their hands, so we could get a big payoff but not draw a lot of attention to ourselves. Simple stuff, this would be question, this would be come into the game, hot deck, this would be I can't see. This would be I can't hear. Go to that table, eat some cards. It means like get rid of the low cards that are still in the deck if you're betting low. Play is over. At that time, in the 70s, the mafia was really running things. The Griffin agency was working it for the casinos. So there was one agency that was doing some detective work, and they're trying to catch card counters. They did not like those card counters. If you're actually playing well, oh no, we don't like you, and we're gonna take your picture, we're gonna show it to everybody. People started getting barred, and sometimes it was a little bit ugly. I remember our Ken Houston got punched and broke about 19 bones in his face. They ended up arresting me, you know, of course, disturbing the peace or whatever. They just were powerful, and they kind of did what they wanted. Once I was card counting in this casino, I won a little bit of money, got the tap on the shoulder. It was the owner of the casino, and he asked me to come with him, bring the chips, and we sat there in his office. He put the chips on the table. We negotiated over these chips. He was gonna take some, and I would take some. And finally, he said, well, you want a ride back to your hotel? And I said, I don't think so. And I called Art, my friend, who was still back at the hotel. He said to me, do you think they might kill you? I said, I think they might. And so he said, I'll send a taxi. I just wasn't smart enough to have any fear about these situations. I really just played to win. I took the money home and lived. They definitely tried to send card counters a message.
I'm gonna have to ask you to come with us, please.
The party was about to come to an end. I got barred from everywhere, really. We were being driven out of Vegas, and we needed to come up with something that would change the game. We needed to find new ways to play. I figured out that you could watch the shuffle and see where the cards went. You could figure out the odds based on what cards are still left in the deck. And ultimately, I got my hands on a computer, and it tracked the shuffle for us. These are the shoes that have a card counting computer hidden in them. There was a switch up and a switch down on each shoe so that we could get any number between 1 and 15. We would tell the computer what cards were being played exactly, and as the cards went into the discard rack, the computer knew the whole stack of cards. Just before we have to play our hands, the computer will give me a negative number or a positive number with buzzers on our insteps on the bottom of our feet. Depending on how positive or how negative it is, I know that that's the edge. A negative number is an edge for the house, and a positive number is an edge for us. When the cards good for the players were coming, we bet big, and when it was good for the dealer, we bet small. That's the trick. These are the homemade lithium batteries. We would put it on our ankle. We used to go through TSA with these. It was just no problem. This would not fly, I don't think, these days. The computer itself, about the size of a pack of cigarettes, is held together by epoxy. My friend Craig, these are his shoes. We became shoemakers. Craig was working on this exact pair of shoes one day. He had the box cutter, and he was cutting, and he slipped. And he shoved the box cutter right into his chest. And he was like, can you guys take me to the emergency room? And the guys were like, no, man, we're going on a play. You know, you can get a taxi. And he was okay. We thought to try out the shoes, we wouldn't start in Vegas. They were a little sharp in Vegas, so we went to England. I was traveling with my friend Munchkin, and he was kind of just like a bodyguard, which is funny, because Munchkin's a small man. He was gonna watch out for me. We didn't know how they were gonna react if they found this device. So we started to use the shoes, and they worked like a charm. So I'm tapping my feet, my shoe is buzzing, and I'm winning.
Oh!
And after we won a few thousand, we quit, and we went to the cage to try to get our money. They said, well, we'll give you a check tomorrow. And we thought, well, that's unusual.
Excuse me?
In Las Vegas, they would always pay you immediately. We were surprised, but we thought, ultimately, it's a small casino, it's a small business, they just don't have this much money. We went home and went back the next morning. We did not guess trouble was waiting. The next morning, we arrived to get our check, maybe play some more. I was all suited up with the computer and the shoes, ready to go. Immediately, they were like, this is Mr. So-and-so from Scotland Yard. He wants to talk to you.
Mr. Purpose?
Yes.
We knew we were in big trouble.
Will you come with me?
The cops said, we're gonna search your hotel. We thought, uh-oh. I didn't know what they were looking for, but the briefcase is there with everything in it. Our backup lithium homemade batteries, all the wires, the other backup computers, the records from where we had played. We knew that if they found it, we were screwed. They took us to the room. They started lifting the mattresses and basically looking everywhere.
No.
All the drawers, behind the curtains, underneath the towels in the bathroom. And they've been everywhere except for the briefcase, which had everything in it.
Nothing.
Finally, they had looked everywhere. They walk over, and he puts his hand on the briefcase, and I think, this is it. We were done. Munchkin and I are just hoping they don't open that briefcase. It had all the evidence he needed to incriminate us. He opens it. Things were about to get bad. He didn't know what he was looking at, and he shuts it. He apparently just wasn't thinking about it. He was just going through the motions. He was done.
Go.
We just got lucky. And we got the money. Got away with it again. Even after that close call, our lesson was that the shoes work. So we took it everywhere else. All across Europe and then back to Nevada and Atlantic City.